We will continue on looking at MySQL Workbench because we want to use that to create a backend for a LibreOffice-based document. I'm going to double-click on MySQL Workbench. We see we've got our single local instance, MySQL 56, and we have nothing here under models. We're going to change that in this video. I'm going to click on our local instance, MySQL 56, and type in our password, secret one. What I want to do now is reverse engineer a database. So I'm coming up here to databases, and I'm clicking on this third one down here that says reverse engineer. This first window says set parameters for connecting to a database. I'm going to leave those as the default, clicking next. It's asking us to sign in. I'm putting in our secret one, the root password. Now it's connecting to the database to fetch the information. I'll click next. Now it's asking us what schemas do we want to select. I want the ODB84 MySQL DB. I'm clicking next. Now it's retrieving the reverse engineer schema objects. Next. Now it's telling us that it has two objects and two are selected. If I want to change this, I can show the filter. There's our two tables, the employee table and the phone. I'm going to hide the filter. I want both objects, and I want to place imported objects on a diagram. Let's click execute. It's reverse engineering right now. Those are done. Next. It's telling us two tables from the schema ODB84 MySQL DB have been reverse engineered. I'll click finish. Here we see we've got something called an EER diagram. That's an enhanced entity relationship diagram. This looks very similar to the relationship diagram that we saw in LibreOffice Base. It's enhanced in the way that we can edit the tables as well as just the relationships. I am going to select the employee table and double-click this to open up a table editing window. I'm going to add a new field. We will call this dpt-id. I'll make this an integer. And we see it's already added into our table on the diagram. I'm going to close our table, and I want to add this back into our database. To do that, I need to come up to database and tell it we want to synchronize the model that we just created to the database that we created this from. I'll click on synchronize model. It's telling us to set the parameters. I'm going to leave all these the defaults. It's setting up the options for synchronizing. Again, leaving everything as a default. Now it's asking us for the root password. Secret one. It tells us that it's connected to the database and fetched the information. Next. It's telling us what database it's going to change. That's this ODB84 MySQL DB. It's got this other one called MyDB. We can delete that. We'll do that in a minute. Going to next. It's retrieved the reverse engineered schema objects. Next. Now it is letting us know that it's going to change the employee table from the model and put that into the source. That's what we want to do. I'm going to click next. Here we see MySQL Workbench has created the SQL to update our table. I'm going to click execute. We see the progress of the model in the database. That looks all complete. Let's close. And when I come back over here to our databases, if I click to open up, show the tables, the employee table, there's our department ID on there, as well as the employee address and employee name. Now that seems kind of a long way around, but if we're creating a brand new set of tables with relationships, it's a lot easier to create them in this model where we can see everything on the page visualized. I mentioned that we're going to get rid of that MyDB. I'm clicking on the MySQL model tab, and we see there's our ODB84 MySQL DB, and it also created a MyDB tab. We don't need that. I'm right-clicking, deleting MyDB. Now we've just got the ODB84 MySQL DB. This is our model. Let's save this file, save model as. I'm going to save this on the desktop, and we will save this as ODB84 MySQLDB.mwb. And we see that MWB is for MySQL Workbench Models. Let's save this and go back over to our EER diagram. I'm going to add in a new table by clicking Tables. We see here place a new table. It names it Table 1, double clicking to bring it up in a new window. I'm going to change the table name to Department, and I'm going to add in a column, DPT-ID for Department ID. That will be an integer, primary key, non-numeric. And we're going to also add in DPT-name for department name. Varchar 45, that's good. We'll make this not null. And again, database, synchronize model. Leave this as the default. Default, I need to type in my root password. Continue on with next. We've got the right table. That's looking good. We're adding in the new department from the model into the source. There's our SQL, execute, close. Coming back over to our database in the tables, I see table employee and table phone. Let's refresh this. And there's our department. I probably should have called this TBL underscore department, so let's change that real quick. TBL DPT. Synchronize model. Next. 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 And it looks like it's going to be okay. Going back over, refresh the tables, and now we've got TBL DPT. I'm going to close this and save. And right up here, we see the ODB84 MySQL DB, as well as this one here that's a backup. So if I double click this to open it up, it's going to open up this MySQL workbench. If I just double click this, we see now we've got ODB84 MySQL DB right down here in the models. And I can click this and go right to it.